Lenses are tools that are all around us, from glasses and cameras to your own eye. So the question is, how do they work? Converging, or convex lenses, are a kind of lens that bends light to a specific point. To see how they bend light, let's go to a diagram. In exams, they often use an arrow as the object, so let's do that as we experiment with this lens. As you can see, the arrow is currently behind this blinking point, which we're going to call the focal point from now on. There is another one of these equidistant from the lens on the other side. The focal point is where all the light converges, and its distance from the center of the lens along the principal axis is called the focal length. Anyways, to find out where the object's image will appear, you have to trace some rays of light emanating from the object and see where they intersect. I find it easiest to go from the top, so let's start there. A ray coming towards the lens, parallel to the focal length, will be refracted to go through the focal point on the other side. A ray coming through the nearer focal point will be refracted parallel to the focal length. Finally, a ray coming through the center of the lens won't be refracted at all. Now we can see where the top of the object is, and so we can just draw it in. There are a few things to notice about this image. Firstly, it's inverted. Secondly, it's enlarged. And finally, it is real. Now, the meaning of real image will become more clear once you know what a virtual image is, but one thing you should know is that a real image can be projected onto a screen. That's basically what it is, if you're ever asked to give a definition. Next, let's try with an arrow at twice the distance of the focal point. This time, we get an interesting result. The size of the image is actually the same as the object. Nevertheless, it is still inverted and real. This is just a consequence of following the rays. As you can see, they converge right there. So in summary, the image of an object at 2f is inverted, is the same size, and is real. It's still real. Now, if the object is beyond 2f, that is to say beyond twice the focal length, then as you'll see after drawing the rays, the image is still inverted and still real, but instead of enlarged or unchanged in size, it is diminished, which just means it's smaller. Basically, an object beyond 2f produces an image that is inverted, that is diminished, and that it is real. However, and this is the hard part, if we were then to change the position of the arrow to in front of the focal point, that is to say closer to the lens than the focal point, and repeat our process with the rays again, you should notice something different. They don't converge at all. So it's clear that the image can't be seen on that side, but where can it be seen from? Well, all you have to do is trace back the rays, and you should see that these virtual rays, that is to say these rays that aren't real, they do converge at a point behind the object. And we can actually just imagine for a second that there is an image there. We'll understand why in a second. So we put that in. Just like with the other image, there are three things that you should notice. It is upright, it is enlarged, and these kind of images are not real, they are virtual images. A virtual image can't be projected onto a screen, but it is what is used in a magnifying glass. Right? To illustrate what I mean by this, let's imagine an eye here. Then when it's looked through the lens, our brain would think that the rays converge behind the object. And so what we would see is the larger virtual image and not the object. So that's essentially all you need to know about converging lenses. I hope you found this helpful, and thank you very much for watching. If you're interested in any more content, be sure to subscribe and or watch some other videos. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.